To track your employee's accrued time in TimeClick, enter admin in the top right of the screen. Enter your password. Navigate to Accrued Time. Mark the box Enable Accrued Time. Select or create a category in the drop-down Accrued Time Categories. If this is your first time setting up accrued time, select Create a New Category. Now select the type, or how often you want their time to accrue, from hourly, by pay period, or annually. Set the amount of time this employee will accrue hourly. You can either use the default name for this category or give it a custom name. I will rename this category Vacation Hourly. Enter a description if desired. Now select Create Category. You can create as many categories as needed to fit the individual circumstances of your employees, and they can be edited and updated later. To update categories, you would come here, select the category, edit the information, and click Update Category. Selecting an employee's name allows you to assign them to rates or categories. Here, I will select the drop-down under Vacation and choose Vacation Hourly, which I just created. Follow the same process for sick and paid time off, or PTO, and repeat these steps for all eligible employees. Click Update Employee. To give an employee their total accrued time balance for the year, navigate to Employees. Select an employee's name and click Edit Employee Record. In the tabs at the top of their record, click Accrued Time. Mark the box Edit Values and fill in the total balances this employee currently has. You can change the categories this employee is assigned to here as well. Now that the initial setup is complete, an employee can begin requesting time off. When an employee requests time off, you will see the notification in your messages if they are enabled, and in the Deduction Approval tab under Active Time Requests. Approving or denying a request opens a prompt asking if you want to notify the employee. Selecting Yes sends that employee a message. When you approve the request, it shows as deducted in your Deduction and Other Time History tab. At the end of the pay period, navigate to the End of Pay Period tab. In the calendar, date ranges highlighted in red indicate that pay period has not been closed out, so there are still accrued time actions from that period that must be updated in the employee's total balances. Select your pay period that must be closed and generate a report. The report will appear on the right side of the window. This report shows how many regular hours they worked, the accrued time they earned based on the rate you assigned them, the accrued time they used and deducted, the previous balance, and the current updated balance as of the end of this pay period. If there are errors in the times of an employee, you must fix the errors before you can see their report and close the pay period. Click the button Fix Error to open a small window allowing you to fix the day this error occurred on. Here, this employee was missing a clock out, so I'll add that quickly and close the window. Generate the report one more time to show the updated report. Close the pay period. Once you close the pay period, it will be highlighted in green on the calendar, and you will not be able to close that pay period again to avoid duplicating deductions. You can now track your accrued time in TimeClick.